when we approach this problem, we usually approach it through a tool set. Perhaps Netscope, for example, for CASB or SASE. You know, we want to prevent people from saving sensitive files within the organization into cloud environments which are uncontrollable. We want to know the inventory of product out there on the globe. Tell me, how does that tool set, that CASB or that SASE solution, benefit from the SailPoint relationship?
So from a CASB standpoint, we partner with CASB providers.
Right.
We have our own cloud access manager, but it's different than a traditional CASB. It's a little bit different. So our swim lane SailPoint.
Yeah.
Right. We're not an IAM organization, right? We're not a password manager. We're not an SSO.
Yeah.
Right. We stay in our swim lanes from a governance standpoint, but we partner very, very closely with the SSO and the MFA and the PAM and the CASBs out there. We partner with those and we do grant and provision access to those tools.
So when you say that, SailPoint, for example, the administrator of the SailPoint environment might say something like, Bill is in Chicago and he's not in California. And you create a policy specific to Bill in Chicago. Well, now, let's say Bill logs in California, for example. What's the behavior of SailPoint, and how does it challenge that particular violation?
I don't know that I would phrase it as a violation, because Bill very, very likely could have traveled to California
to log in, which is
one of the beauties of SailPoint, because we're managing that identity and it's not location specific.
That's right.
We can control it. Now, we can create specific roles. Mm-hmm. Let's say Bill's in California and everyone in that office has access to four or five very specific applications.
Okay.
When Bill's in California, we can grant or provision access to those applications.
Right on.
And then when he goes back home, we can pull that access.
Right on.
So depending on the location, we can give permission to those access.